Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about X-ray spectroscopy. X-ray spectroscopy is a very important unit for semester exam point of view. In this particular video, we are going to discuss about the basic introduction of X-ray spectroscopy. So basically, what is X-ray spectroscopy? So X-ray spectroscopy is a general term for several spectroscopic technique for characterization of material by using X-ray excitations. X-ray spectroscopy is just a general term like mass spectrometry and vibration IR spectroscopy. This all kind of spectroscopy we read, and that kind X-ray spectroscopy is one of the those kind of spectroscopy technique. So basically, it is when we take a sample, a material, then strike a X-ray in this materials to know the properties of that particular materials and characterizations of that materials. So this technique is known as X-ray spectroscopy by using the X-ray radiation as a radiation source to characterize some materials or samples. That technique is known as X-ray spectroscopy. X-ray were discovered by Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen in 1895 in the course of a systematic study to observe if any radiation could be produced which would traverse matter opaque to ordinary light. So basically, X-ray radiations or X-rays were discovered by Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen in 1895 during the systematic study. And observe some radiations, and he just define a radiations like this is the matter, and this is ordinary light. When this ordinary light is traversed from this matter, then some opaque of the radiation, and this opaque radiation is known as a radiations. Okay, so basically the radiation is also a ordinary lights. When the ordinary lights traverse from the matters or sample, then it's called a radiation. It is just a kind of radiation, and that something is Wilhelm Conrad is also observed in his observations. And X-rays are electromagnetic radiations, basically one of the kind of electromagnetic radiations with wavelength of the order of 10 to the power 10 meter. Okay, electromagnetic radiation is used in almost all spectroscopic technique, and X-ray is also one of the kind of electromagnetic radiations. That's why electromagnetic radiations or X-ray is used in X-ray spectroscopy. Okay, now we are going to discuss about three important methods, like very important methods to determine the molecular structure. Okay, by using these three kind of method, we determine the molecular structure of any kind of sample. This three method is X-ray absorption method, X-ray fluorescence or emission method, and third is X-ray diffraction method. Three important method. So first important method is, in X-ray absorption method, a beam of X-ray is allowed to pass through the sample, and the attenuation or fraction of X-ray photons absorbed is considered to be a measure of the concentration of the absorbing substance. This is the basic theory portion of this method. Now we understood this method very well by using this diagram. So this is the incident X-ray, and this is sample. So what is the absorbed radiation? Basically, sample is absorb some radiation when X-rays incident X-ray are bombard to the sample, then sample absorb some radiations, and that radiation is known as absorbed radiations, and rest of the radiation are transmitted by this sample, and this radiation is known as transmitted radiations. To calculate the absorbed radiation, we have to minus transmitted radiation and incident radiation, then we got to know the amount of absorbed radiations that absorbed by this sample. Okay, so this is absorbed radiations, and second important is in X-ray fluorescence or emission method, X-ray are generated within the sample and by measuring the wavelength and intensity of generated X-ray, one can perform the analysis. By using this fluorescence method, we can easily find out the wavelength of X-ray, wavelength and intensity generated of X-rays. Okay, this is the very important method to generate the wavelength and intensity of any X-rays. So what happened? This is incident X-ray and this is sample. So in sample, we take atoms and this. And when incident X-ray or radiations bombard to the these atoms and the inner cell of the this atom, so they present an electron. And when X-ray is bombarded in this cell, then this electron is excited and go to the upper electron and go to the upper this upper cell, this electron go to the upper cell, and after some time when it's got relaxed, then in relaxation state it's also in it's came to the same position. So in this process, this electron is generated some energy and some kind of radiations. That radiation is known as fluorescent radiations, and the wavelength of this radiation is longer, very longer than this incident X-ray. Okay, this is the one of the kind of atoms, and this is known as fluorescence radiations or emission radiations. So this is the basic theory of fluorescence emission radiation. Third is X-ray diffraction method are based on the scattering of X-ray by crystal. So when incident X-ray strike to the sample, then when atoms present in the particular sample, okay, it's all depend on the atoms present in the particular sample. When this when we use the crystalline form of sample, then diffracted then radiation are got diffracted by it means like when incident radiations attack to the sample, then when we use the crystal form of sample, then it diffract that radiation in different angle, and that radiation is known as diffracted radiations. So this is very important. So that is very important methods. By using this all methods, we can determine the molecular structure. Now, among X-ray absorption method, X-ray fluorescent method and X-ray diffraction method, the last technique is most convenient and hence widely used physical procedure for the complete determination of molecular structure. So basically three are very important, but the most important method is diffraction method because it is most widely used physical procedure for the complete determination of molecular structure. By using this method, we can just got the detailed determination of the present molecule sample. One of the prerequisites for the X-ray diffraction to be applicable is that the material should be crystalline in nature. X-ray analysis could be successfully employed for obtaining. Okay, so this is very important prerequisites for using this diffraction method. It must be a crystalline, okay? It should be a crystalline in nature, the material or sample we use. Successfully employed for obtaining a complete electron distribution in the molecule, information about the intermolecular interaction in the molecule, a detailed picture of the thermal vibrations of each atom in the crystals. Okay, these three important we can obtain after using the diffraction method. We got to know the electron distribution of in the molecules. We use the molecule and we got to know the electron, how electron distributions of that molecule, and information about intermolecular interaction of the molecule, and a detailed picture of the thermal vibration of each atom in the crystals. Okay, so this is the complete detailed explanations and basic about the X-ray spectroscopy. It's basic introduction. In my upcoming videos, I'm going we are discuss about all topic related to X-ray spectroscopy. We can and I provide a handmade notes, which is very important for your exam preparations. And I hope this lecture video is helpful for your exam preparations and your concept building for X-ray spectroscopy. If helpful, so please support, like, share and subscribe to my channel, and thank you so much for watching.